Algal oil is DHA. And DHA is important for neuronal structure. No question, no argument. So if you're not getting your DHA from anywhere, then algal oil is a way to get DHA. But algal oil is not a source of EPA. Now, EPA is necessary for neurotransmission. The EPA is the thing that makes fish oil smell like fish. DHA is pretty clean. So it's easy to add DHA to stuff. It's easy to add algal oil to stuff. But EPA is another story, because EPA carries that fishy smell along with it. So if you are grinding up salmon livers to get EPA and DHA, you'll get both. Okay, but if you're going to just take the algae and basically develop this clean, colorless, tasteless, odorless algal oil that you basically can add to food, they've had to remove the EPA for that reason. So, in fact, algal oil provides an important source of DHA, but it is not a significant source of EPA for that reason. So that it remains a problem.
I didn't realize that. Important information here, because I think a lot of people that are on a plant-based diet or vegan diet assume that if they're taking that supplement, the algal oil, that they're getting everything that somebody would get from a fish oil.
You can get your ALA from your vegetables. You can get your DHA from algal oil, but you're still going to be EPA deficient.
And now that we're on that vegan topic, and we know there's this hole within the diet and supplementing, any other concerns for somebody on that diet, things that they're not getting or things that they're getting too much of that are causing problems? And let's relate it to the mitochondria and metabolic health if we can. Use that as our common thread today.
Sure. Not so much the metabolic health. I mean, I think mitochondrial health is probably reasonable otherwise, but, you know, obviously you need those omega-3s to make those mitochondria, you know, function at peak efficiency. But there are two things that are low in a vegan diet that are an issue, and they're two amino acids, tryptophan and methionine. So tryptophan is the rarest amino acid, and methionine is the second rarest amino acid. And for the most part, vegetable protein is relatively low in both tryptophan and methionine. And you need both. Tryptophan is the precursor to serotonin, and serotonin is the contentment, happiness neurotransmitter. Does a lot of things. You know, your gut bacteria make serotonin, but they need tryptophan in order to do it. And if they don't have the tryptophan to do it, then you get all sorts of issues in your gut, including gut inflammation and also the lack of carriage of serotonin up the afferent vagus nerve to the brain. And so tryptophan depletion is associated with irritability and depression. And also methionine. Methionine is a primary source of methyl groups. And you need methyl groups because you have to methylate proteins. It's essential. And also because there's sulfur. And methionine, both methyl and also sulfur. And you need the sulfur as a reducing agent, an antioxidant, in order to prevent oxidation. And so methionine is a primary contributor to S-adenosyl methionine, which is necessary to create glutathione. And glutathione is the liver's endogenous antioxidant. So if you're methionine deficient, you're going to be glutathione deficient, in which case your liver is going to have decreased oxidative capacity, which is not good, because that's a great way to damage your liver too.
If you enjoyed that clip, press here for the full episode. I'll see you over there.
Ultimately, it's not what's in the food, it's what's been done to the food that matters. Everything fructose does to the mitochondria is designed to inhibit its functioning. It's metabolic health that drives